Welcome back friends. In this video we are going to talk about how to install IntelliJ and its configuration. I removed my IntelliJ from my laptop. I was using this version 2020.2.3. This community edition I was using in my laptop. I downloaded latest version of IntelliJ and tried to set up an IntelliJ with my billing system, but that is not at all working. The reason is the latest version of IntelliJ is not supporting the map struct. I tried my level best, I tried a lot, but it's not at all working. It's giving some weird error. I don't see any help also in the Google. So I tried with my old version, the same version which I'm showing, right? The same version 2020.2.3, that same version I have used, that is working fine. So please download the IntelliJ, this version. I will guide you how to download this older version. This is not a much older version. This is a previous version of the current latest version. Okay. Type download IntelliJ community version. Click the first result. It will navigate to in this page. This is the latest version of community. Latest version of IntelliJ community version. Okay. Don't download this. We need to download previous version. Scroll down the left corner, you can see other version. Click the other version, go to here, select the drop down 2020.2.3. We need that version, okay? Then you can see here Windows exe 2020.2.3. This one we need to download. Please, released 6 October 2020. This version only I used in my laptop, okay? We need to download this version. When you see here, built on October 6, 2020, here released October 6, 2020, build version is 2020.2.766026. The same thing here, 2020.2.766026. okay, this is the previous version of current updated version. Okay, download this. I have already downloaded this version, so I don't want to download now. I am cancelling it. Once you downloaded the our IntelliJ version, click the setup. This is the IntelliJ installation wizard. Click next. Select your path where you want to install. I don't want to change my path. I want to leave it as it is. You can install at the SQL program files. Click next. Then click next. Okay, here I want to create a shortcut for 64-bit. Then click next. Install. Now IntelliJ is installing. Click checkbox, then click finish. Now IntelliJ will open. Now I want to import my billing system. This billing system, this is a workspace, IntelliJ iPhone workspace. I have created a new folder. Inside the folder, I want to keep my billing system project. Okay, this I have done previously. I want to remove that now. I'll going to remove this entirely. Then I'll going to remove this also. These are downloaded from the website. Go to pinepad.insight. Click downloads. You will be getting this page. Then click download button. Then save it. Once downloaded, extract this, extract here. After extracting the building system iPhone main, rename this folder to building system. Okay, don't forget this. This step is very, very important. You need to rename to building system. Don't keep it building system iPhone main. Otherwise, you cannot set up the building system project. Okay, after renaming, I want to import this project to my IntelliJ. I already opened it asking. Okay. Click OK. Keep it. Do not import settings. Click OK. Now I want to theme this white color theme. Select that. Next, click next. Then stop. Okay. Once open this window, it asking new project, open or import, or it asking get from the version control. We need to choose second option, open or import. We need to import our billing system from here, right? Okay, so we need to select second option. I want to keep this billing system inside a IntelliJ workspace. Copy this path and paste it here. Select billing system. Under billing system, select pom.xml file. It asking open as a project, open as a file. Select open as a project. It is importing now. It will take some time. If you are importing very first time, definitely it will take more time. Okay. Now imported successfully. Let me open some files. When you open this file, it asking setup SDK. Java JDK. JDK is not yet setup. We need to set up that. Okay. Click that setup SDK. It asking 1.8. Whatever version we have installed in the laptop, in our computer, it will ask automatically. Just select that. Now we have done with the JDK setup. Now it's showing some error, right? A log, get first name, get last name. The reason is we are using Lombak library. We have to set up Lombak library in IntelliJ. IntelliJ doesn't come with Lombak. IntelliJ doesn't come with Lombak. We have to integrate. For that, go to File, Settings, click Plugin. Here we need to type Lombak. We need to install Lombak plugin. Okay, type Lombak. It's showing here Lombak with a button called install. Click install. Accept it. Now Lombak is installed successfully. After successful installation, it shows installed. Then click OK. It's saying Lombak requires annotation processing. Click enable. After doing this step, see the errors are gone. Errors are gone. We have successfully installed IntelliJ. Also, we have configured Lombak in IntelliJ. In the next video, I will going to show how to set up a DB configuration. How to set up a DB configuration. As of now, we have completed the IntelliJ installation and Lombak configuration. We are good now. We have to create a database and a database username. Those things we need to create. Then only we can run this application. In the YAML file, right? Application YAML file. Whatever username and database is available here, we need to create those things in MySQL. In the next video, I will going to show that. Then we can run our billing system. Until then, bye bye from Suresh. Still not subscribe this channel? Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.